I don't care who killed the prostitutes.
If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers,
it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
Once the mirror's fixed, we can use it to find that crooked bastard. Or at least wherever he hangs his hat. That's how Crane kept tabs on him. And everybody else. I'd say he was abusing the privilege. He was probably spying on all of us.
He was probably spying on me.
Anyway...
No, it's fine. You did excellent work, Bigby.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Unbelievable. Pompous ass.
Why don't you go fuck off until I'm good and ready?
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know.
I found it at the butcher shop, the cut above. It was in Crane's coat. There was a lot of weird magic going on there. That has something to do with it. Other than that, the last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had some...
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Bufkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
Do you need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No budge on that bloody glamour. I only came in to see him.
Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallop because of you.
I'm starting to think you don't take me seriously, Toad. How many times have I told you to get glamored up? You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, hmm? Is he going to the farm too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst kept secret in Fable Town.
Colin isn't your concern. You should worry about your own fucking situation, Toad.
Exactly, worry about your own
bastard.
Situation. Everybody got their own way.
They came out wrong.
Of breaking rules and do whatever they want.
If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I see a way for me and me boy to stay.
Trust me, I see that.
I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just wanna stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest to watch. Please, Sheriff, Don't take TJ from the only army knows. This old glamour rule is oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different.
Look, I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, that's not entirely up to me.
Oh, thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get this sorted and I'll be glamour to the nines, I will.
I'm just standing, staring at the glass. That's why I like it, just one little piece.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason.
Look, I'll take care of it later. I told him we'd work it out so he'd get out of our hair. We don't have time to worry about that right now.
Bigby, what did I tell you?
If he's unglamored when this whole thing is over, I'll send him to the farm. No questions asked, okay?
Fine, we'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons.
I don't know, but when I catch the fucker who did this, I'll find out why.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
Oh, you got it.
I have to say, I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
Are you really sure you want to see him?
Probably naked getting tortured.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
It's the Bloody Mary. Whoa.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction and looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you having trouble with the rhyme, Sheriff?
Mirror, mirror, no time to pout. So where does Crooked Man hang out? I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold off.
The door. It moves.
Yeah, Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Every hour or something?
This can't be like it was with Tweedledum. I don't care if it gets out of hand. You don't let it come to that. I know that emotions can run high. And you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I'll catch him and bring him back here, alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
But soon he mended his evil ways.